Jesus loves me. 4 and 5, He's by my side. 6 and 7, He's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, I sing it again. I can always count on Him. I can always count on Jesus.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Coral, and welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV! Hosted by Coral, where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV!
What is up? How's it going? What it do? Just kidding, seriously. But what's up? Do you know what this is? It is a priceless family heirloom. Apparently this belonged to my grandpa, and his grandpa, and his grandpa's grandpa. But you know what the coolest part of it is? It's also a time machine. No matter what time of the day it is, as long as I tap this here time device, it always brings me back to 3:15. Pretty cool, right? So guess what I do with my cool time clock? I went back in time and did something I always wanted to do. It ain't skydiving. It ain't bull riding. It ain't finger painting. And it sure ain't traveling back to Florida to teach everyone how to juggle iguanas. I don't do that anymore. No sir, no ma'am. I, Carl Eugene Ulysses Patricia Abercrombie and Fitch Hooper, have started a, drumroll please, basketball team. I started a basketball team. That's right, I'm basically like LeBron Jordan. Touchdown. TJ, what's up?
Carl, what's going on, man? How you been?
Really, really well. Like, really well. Super well, TJ.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, man. So tell me, man, what's got you in such a good mood today?
Well, I finally did it, TJ.
Okay, so you did what?
I did it.
Carl, what'd you do?
TJ, I did it.
Carl, I don't know what you're talking about, friend. What did you do?
I started a basketball team, TJ.
What?
I did it!
So, how did that happen? I thought you gave up on that idea last time.
Well, it's funny that you should mention time, because time is exactly what fixed everything.
Carl, why are you talking in that I have a time machine that I use to go back in time to convince my friends to join my basketball team, boys?
Because that's exactly what I did. I have a time machine, and I used it to go back in time to convince my friends to join a basketball team.
Right, but how did going back in time change anything?
Well, I never asked my friends before, but this time when I went back in time, I asked them. So I found out that apparently one of my friends always wanted to be in a basketball team. So I talked to him and we got 4 other people to be part of a basketball team. Now we got a basketball team, thanks to time travel.
Dude, yeah, congratulations. I mean, I do have one question though.
What's that?
Well, basketball teams are made up of 5 people, right?
Sure.
You just said you had 6 people.
Sure.
So,
What?
Looks like you have one too many people.
Oh no, oh no! I have too many people! This ruins everything! Now I have to choose between Garrett and Dave!
Well, maybe. But I think our story today may be able to help you out.
You sure?
Absolutely. Let's take a look at Acts chapter 1. So you know how there were 12 disciples, right?
Judas left, right?
Exactly. So there was only 11 now, and the disciples needed to add one more disciple.
Oh, so they just picked one person, right?
Well, you see, it wasn't that easy. They had two different people who could take the spot, but they could only choose one.
Oh, wow. That's kind of similar to the situation I'm in right now.
Yeah. The disciples, they were a team. So they decided to pray to God for the answer, and then they did something to help them make the decision.
A coin toss?
Not quite. They cast lots.
What does that mean?
It was a way for them to make a decision without any of them playing favorites.
Oh, so they found out who it was going to be?
They knew either of them would be a good fit for the team.
Oh, so they found out who it was going to be?
They did. It was either going to be a man named Matthias or Barsabbas. And after they cast the lots, it was decided that Matthias would be the new disciple.
Good for him. Matthias made the team. I'm kind of sad for Barsabbas, though.
Oh, because he didn't make the team?
Yeah, and that's what I'm scared of with my basketball team. I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings.
Well, I have some good news for you, Carl. Barsabbas made the team too.
But you just said...
I know. But when it comes to being on the team for Jesus, everyone can be on the team.
What do you mean?
Well, even though Matthias was the 12th disciple, God still had plans for Barsabbas too. God needs everyone to be a part of the team because everyone can do something special.
Wow, I guess you're right. So I can be a disciple of Jesus too?
Absolutely. And you know what, Carl? Just because you have 6 people on your team doesn't mean that you have to get rid of any of them.
I guess you're right. There's a lot of basketball to get played. And more importantly than that, God has a lot of work for us to do. So we need everyone.
Exactly. And with our friends. And the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work.
Hey, DJ! That's our big idea, buddy.
Today's big idea is the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work.
So let's say it out loud on the count of 3. 1.
2. 3.
The Holy Spirit helps us do God's work. Yes. Yes. DJ knows. Glad we talked because I was really stressing out about the whole thing. I wish I could go back in time and maybe uninvite someone so I don't have to choose. Oh wait, I can.
Carl, you know you're not doing any traveling anytime soon. Bright, your watch is broken.
Whoa, my buddy Garrett just texted me. He says he don't want to play basketball anymore. He says he's taking up competitive napping.
Oh, well, good for Garrett.
See, it works. Time travel. It's dangerous. Dangerous game, but I'm willing to risk it.
Yeah. Okay, kids. We'll see you guys next week.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Road TV.
You dug through your old stuff too. Then we got to talk to a friend who loves God in Puerto Rico. Do you want to see something else I found? It's a tool belt. When I asked my dad where it came from, he told me about a really bad storm that happened in Louisiana before I was born. There was so much water from the rain that it flooded and filled up people's houses. It was a really hard time for everyone. The water ruined things they loved and needed. So my dad and some friends went to help them rebuild their houses. Louisiana is far away from New York. I bet that was a long road trip. They worked for days and days. I asked my dad why he worked for so long and traveled so far to help. He told me that we help each other when we experience God's love. God helps us when we help others. I I really like the thought of building homes and things for people, but I wonder what I can do to help. What type of work I can do for God? Maybe today's Bible story might help.
It's time for our Bible story. Our story today comes from the book of Acts, chapter 1. But this book isn't about an axe. It's about actions, the things that we do. This book tells the story of the works of Jesus' followers who started the church, guided by the Holy Spirit. Our story for today finds those very followers facing a tough question. Do you know what Jesus' band of followers were called? They were called disciples. There were 12 of them, and each of them had an important role. Sadly, one of them, named Judas, made some bad decisions that led to Jesus being captured. His actions caused him to give up his role as one of the 12 disciples. It was sad, and it upset Jesus and all of the disciples, but they couldn't stay sad. There was work to do. After Jesus died and came back to the disciples one last time, they knew that the good news of God had to be spread everywhere. And in order to do that, they needed to find someone who could take on the leadership that Judas left. It was a big decision. They narrowed it down to two: Justus and Matthias. The truth was, the decision was too big for them to make. So they went to the Holy Spirit in prayer, believing that that would lead them to the right person. After praying, they cast lots. Casting lots was basically like rolling dice. But they weren't depending on casting lots to tell them what to do. They were depending on the Holy Spirit to make a call. And in fact, that's exactly what the Holy Spirit did. Matthias was chosen to take Judas's spot. Just like Jesus' disciples, we all have work to do for God, like telling others about God's love and what Jesus did for them. But we can trust the Holy Spirit to help us with the work and any tough decisions we need to make. The disciples did that. And so can we, because the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work.
I got it! I thought of something I can do to help others too. My dad reminded me of a place where I can pack lunches for other kids who don't always have all the food that they need. We're going to go together this week. The kids who get to get the meals go to school where I go to school, and they get to take the food home. It will help them take care of themselves when there isn't enough. I can definitely help others by putting the meals together and praying for their situations. They are kids just like me. I am so excited I can do something for God in my own way. What are some ways you can do God's work? Let me know next time, okay? Remember, the Holy Spirit helps us do God's work. Thanks for growing with me, friends.